This is a short video about the position record button on a Heidenhain control. It's a really useful tool to have in your toolbox. What it means is that you can move to a position, you could be in hand wheel, just milling something by hand around this component in hand wheel and actually record the positions as you go. So for example, in face milling, if you've got an unusual shape to get around, you can move around that shape recording the positions, and then when you come to do your next component, it'll be in the right place and it'll follow that path. So watch this video and you'll see how it's done. So the first thing I'm going to do is, using my hand wheel up here, I'm going to position my x-axis and my y-axis to the start point of where I want to start machining. So you would move this around with your hand wheel. This is a simulator, so I can't really do that. But you'll end up with figures that are not nice round figures, but don't worry too much about that. Having got to that position, move into your edit mode. And you need to define a tool and call that tool. And then what we're going to do is a linear move. And I'm going to use the position record button here. When I press that, it asks me to record which axis. Make sure you get the right one. I'm going to record the x-axis position, the current x-axis position, then y. I'm going to record the current y-axis position. You can do this with x, y, and z. And it's just picking up where the machine is in the current coordinate system. So I've got that, and then I'm going to say no enter to that, and I'm going to move this at rapid, and I will probably turn on the spindle there. So I'm just going to end that, and then at that point there, I'm also going to bring my tool down, and I'm going to say Z, and I'm going to take Z to zero, enter, no enter on that, rapid again. This time we'll put the coolant on and just end it. So we've in the start position, the Z axis is down, and we're all ready to start cutting metal. Now you can actually bring this to this position, start your spindle and actually start cutting metal. It doesn't matter if you go slightly off track because we're only face milling. The main thing is that you can see this clear line to where you're going to end up. So what I'm going to do then is go back to my hand wheel, and I would move the display around. Sorry, I've got the Z axis, I want the X. I'd move the X and move the Y until I got to my position. I have cheated slightly on this because, I mean, I know roughly where this has got to end up. So I'm going to go to my second position now, and I've actually machined this part as I'm doing it, so I can see that I've got it about right and I'm in the correct position. Go to my edit mode again, and we'll do another line, and this time we use a position record. We want the X position record, we want the Y. As I say, don't worry if these are not nice round figures. I know it'll annoy me, but hopefully it won't annoy you. No enter, and this time I'm actually machining now, so I need a feed rate. We're going nice and slow at 250 there, and we don't need any M codes, and that lands us up at the second position. So it's machine that. Need to go into the hand wheel mode again and start moving these axes until we get to our next position. So again, I'm round about this sort of figure, 151 by 34. But as I say, it doesn't have to be spot on, but I've machined up to the other corner now. So now I'm going to go into edit again, and I'm going to input another line, another linear move, sorry. And I'm going to record the current X position. And then I'm going to record the current Y position. And I don't really need anything else there because I've got a feed rate. And that's my next position. Go into hand wheel again, and then move these to your third position. And then what we're going to do then is exactly the same thing again. Go into the edit mode, another linear move, record the X and then the Y. This is much better than trying to work out where these figures are. I'm sure you get this, that this is going to save you quite a lot of time. because we know now that our path for our face milling, it's a bit time consuming, yes, but you do end up with a nice neat path, and you've got none of this embarrassing where the cutter's, you know, up in the stratosphere, up in the ozone layer, and cutting fresh air, whatever. We don't want that. We want this cutter to be in the correct place. So then we're going to go into our hand wheel mode again. So I'm going to my hand wheel mode again, and as I say, I'm going to move it around, get it to where I want it to be. I'm going to end up at my final position. I've machined off the part now, and this 18565, but you'll find this just by moving the cutter around and getting to the right place, and providing you can see where these lines will be, you'll be just fine. You'll end up. So let's go into the edit mode again, and we'll do another linear move, and this time we'll record the X position and the Y position and just end it. And then you'll notice that I've got this M25, which would take it up in the air. So that would be your program to actually face mill that part. So you've actually recorded the positions as they are on the screen. You know the correct because you've guided it through. It's a kind of, this is called teaching on some controls. I think there's various controls that have got it. But I just think that this is a really, really useful feature to have. You know, if you want to, I don't know, you might want to clock something up and just see exactly where it is in relation to your datum. And you can just record the position in here just by pressing this position record button.